Hello and good day, welcome to our YouTube channel God's Promises, and to this video will be a fast concise overview. Book of Genesis, chapter 48. Let's get started now. The story of Genesis 48 focuses on the blessings that Jacob, also known as Israel, gives to his grandsons, Manasseh and Ephraim. The story is significant because it reveals the way God works through generations and how blessings can impact the future. In this essay, we will examine the story of Genesis 48 and its lessons and teaching applications. The story of Genesis 48 takes place near the end of Jacob's life when he was living in Egypt with his son Joseph. Joseph had risen to a position of power in Egypt and had become a great help to his family. Jacob became ill, and Joseph brought his two sons, Manasseh and Ephraim, to see him. Jacob told Joseph that he would adopt his two grandsons as his own, giving them equal share of the inheritance with his other sons. In the story, Jacob placed his right hand on Ephraim, the older son, and his left hand on Manasseh, the older son, to give them his blessings. Joseph, noticing that his father had his hands crossed, tried to correct him, but Jacob explained that he knew what he was doing. Jacob had given the greater blessing to Ephraim, who would become a great nation. One of the key lessons from this story is the importance of blessings. Jacob's blessings show that they were not just words or good wishes, but they had power and could change the course of someone's life. It is important to seek blessings from our parents, elders, and spiritual leaders, as they can have a significant impact on our lives. As believers, we can also seek God's blessings through prayer and obedience to His will. Another lesson from this story is that God works through generations. Jacob's blessings show that his descendants would be significant in God's plan for the world. The blessings passed down to Josephson's would have impact on future generations, and ultimately, would play a role in the fulfillment of God's promises. This reminds us that our actions and decisions can impact future generations, and we should strive to leave a positive legacy. Furthermore, this story shows that God's blessings do not necessarily follow the natural order of things. In ancient cultures, the firstborn son would usually receive the greater inheritance and blessing. However, God's plan and blessing do not always follow human traditions or expectations. In this case, Jacob intentionally gave the greater blessing to Ephraim, the older son. This reminds us that God's ways are higher than ours, and we should trust in His plans for our lives, even when they do not follow our expectations. The story of Genesis 48 also teaches us about the importance of family. Despite all the trials and tribulations Jacob's family faced, they remained close-knit and loyal to one another. This is evident in the way Joseph cared for his father and brought his sons to see him. Similarly, Jacob adopted Joseph's sons as his own and blessed them. This reminds us of the importance of familial relationships and the value of caring for our loved ones. Moreover, this story shows that God is faithful to His promises. Through the book of Genesis, God made many promises to Jacob and his descendants. Despite the challenges and setbacks they faced, God remained faithful to His promises. The blessings Jacob gave to his grandsons were not just empty words, but they were a fulfillment of God's promises. This reminds us that we can trust in God's promises and have faith that He will fulfill them. Finally, the story demonstrates the importance of forgiveness and reconciliation. Joseph had been sold into slavery by his brothers, but he chose to forgive them and work towards reconciliation. When he brings his sons to Jacob, he is seeking to restore the broken relationship between himself and his family. As Christians, we are also called to forgive and seek reconciliation with those who have wronged us. This includes forgiving those who have hurt us deeply, as Joseph did with his brothers. Through forgiveness and reconciliation, We can experience a and restoration in our relationships and live out the values of love and forgiveness that Christ modeled for us. In conclusion, the story of Genesis 48 teaches important lessons about passing down blessings, recognizing God's sovereignty, and practicing forgiveness and reconciliation. These teachings are relevant for believers today as we seek to live out our faith and build strong relationships with others. Por favor, compartilhe conosco seu capítulo bíblico favorito, abaixo na seção de comentários. Não se esqueça de curtir e se inscrever, isso realmente ajuda nosso canal a crescer, ansioso para vê-lo de volta aqui para o nosso próximo vídeo. Cuide-se sempre bem!